Experts, academics, and the financial media have all expressed concern over passive investing strategies. Should you be concerned? This video will summarize and simplify the views of successful investors like Seth Klarman of the Baupost Group, Dr. Michael Berry of Big Short fame, and Mike Green, an investor who predicted the blow-up of a VIX ETF. We have also relied on academic papers and articles in the media. Please see the video description for more details on these sources. This video will first get to the core of what passive investing is. Next, we will show how passive investing dominates stock pricing. This will lead to a discussion of investing flows and how they explain all the distortions in the US stock market today. Finally, we will present our thesis for the endgame as passive investing fails. Passive investing is a simple algorithm. If investors add money to the strategy, passive funds buy the underlying stocks in an index. If investors redeem, passive funds must sell. There is no further thought process or valuation work. Due to steady returns and aggressive lobbying, passive has increased its market share every year for over a decade. As a result, passive is now over 43% of all professionally managed money. Most 401ks have only one fund, a target date fund, which is a passive index fund. This continued steady success means two important things. First, more and more shares are locked up in passive funds, as these funds will never sell while they enjoy inflows. Second, additional inflows have a smaller supply to buy from. Since passive is an algorithm, it has no choice but to continue buying. This continued buying has collectively made passive funds the largest holders of nearly every US company. This, along with institutional and insider ownership, has materially reduced the float or tradable shares of every stock. Low floats can be heavily influenced by day-to-day market activity or flows. Since all the flows on the buy side are coming from passive, these strategies have full control over the pricing of US equities. Normally, fundamentals like profits drive stock prices. Now, stocks with the largest weights in the index receive the most flows, and as a result, continue to outperform well beyond their fundamentals. Flows also explain why stocks have V-shaped recoveries from sell-offs. Ultimately, volatility on the upside and downside will continue to increase while passive is in control. This chart from Mike Green's work shows co-movement of US stocks over time. You can see how stocks have an increased propensity to move as a group. With passive investors buying an entire index, this should be no surprise. However, increased co-movement eliminates the benefits of diversification, adding large risks to portfolios. So what is happening now in markets? Currently, even at record valuations, the risks are to the upside. The orange slice on the chart represents the amount of shares remaining in active managers. There are not a lot of shares available for passive to buy, so as money continues to flow into passive, prices must rise to entice active managers to sell. This is why markets melt up month by month. Once passive buys a share, it stays in their vault indefinitely. No valuation or price will cause passive to sell, only outflows from their customers. Passive firms have never had a net outflow on an annual basis from their strategies, so we have never seen the chaos this will cause. However, until there are outflows, we believe upward volatility will increase as this low float dynamic persists. But when it ends, the virtuous cycle of stock price melt-ups reverses into a vicious cycle when passive needs to sell. The blue section of this chart needs to sell, and they cannot sell to each other. That leaves the small orange slice to absorb all passive investing, which cannot happen at current valuations. When will this occur? We believe within the next 3 years. US demographics are aging, and retirees need to sell down equities as they age. The target date funds in 401ks also sell as employees get older, rebalancing stocks for bonds. Perhaps before this happens, if stocks rise at an increasing rate, some passive participants may elect to sell high to lock in gains. Again, they will have no one to sell to, as passive has never experienced sustained outflows before and has never had to find buyers for stocks at these levels. Downward volatility will be immense as passive strategies are algorithms. They must sell if redemptions are received, and there is no margin for error. When does the selling end? When active is interested and capable of buying passive sell orders, and passive is small enough to stop influencing valuations. We believe this is around a fair value level of 2,000 for the S&P 500. Remember, upward volatility may happen first, driving the S&P even higher than its current levels, but fair value only grows slowly with the fundamentals. Our firm, Frank Capital, has ways to take advantage of this and protect on the downside, even without selling your passive investments. We believe the risks are immense, and retirements are at risk for anyone over the age of 50. Please see our website, frankcapitalpartners.com, for more information, and contact us to learn more about our strategies and our book on passive investing, Slaughterhouse 500.